Yet another session and yet another record high for Indian equity markets. Nifty clocked gains of around 0.2% to touch sharp around that 9,675 mark for the first time. After making the flat start today in the trade, we saw Nifty pretty much trading in a thin range of around 50 points for that matter, and concluding not far away from the day's high, just about that 9,675 with gains of around 21 points. That's that in terms of the Nifty moments. We are today in conversation with Hadrian Mendonca, the technical analyst of India Infoline. Last time we had a conversation, I remember you telling us that you've been pretty bullish on Nifty and you've been initiating, subscribing buy calls ever since Nifty has dipped in from December 2016. What's your view going forward now?
Yeah, see, honestly speaking, I've never seen Nifty in such a strong trend in the recent past, and I see no reason to actually change my view, because every dip is turning out to be a good opportunity to buy. So it is always better to be with the trend. Trend is your friend until it bends. So it is better to stick with the trend. And currently, even a 100-point decline has been utilized to jump in and buy stocks. So today, if you see, Nifty is already broken out above 9650 levels, and this is something very crucial, because it has broken from a channel on the daily charts. And in my opinion, as long as we sustain over 9650, I think the projected target is coming around 9870. Keeping 2 to 3 weeks perspective, we should be there. So it is a buy on dip strategy.
So 9870 is the mark we may be looking at. But for now, when it comes to the futures and options space, considering the fact that, well, it's been a reasonably quiet day with respect to options, we've seen more writing in the puts. So the 9600 and the 9700 puts is where we are looking at an addition towards open interest, which brings me to maximum OI. That stands at the 9500 put. And, well, 9700 a call, but we don't have the 9800 too far away. So that would be the range that we're looking for, at least as far as the near-term range is concerned. Hadrian, as far as the Nifty Bank goes, we're looking at levels around 23,400. Where do you see that moving in?
Yeah, see, Nifty Bank is actually doing something different as compared to the Nifty currently. So it's trading in a 500 band trading range, that is from 23,000 to 20,500. So either of the bands have to be broken for any kind of a specific direction to be taken. So I am pretty confident that this consolidation that is happening, this 500 points range, I am confident that 23,500 is something that Bank Nifty would see breaking. And then post that, we are expecting another 500 points upswing. So 24,000 level is something that I am expecting.
Sure. So, Aniki, we've had plenty of gainers. Of course, India Bulls Housing Finance stands at the top of the Nifty gainers in today's job.
I think clearly the action lies in mid-cap space after the GST rates came over the weekend. But just quickly addressing the top gainers and losers for the day, we had something like India Bulls Housing Finance, which ended the day with gains of around 3%. Next we have is Yes Bank, which too ended with gains of around 2.6%. TCS with 1.99%. On the flip side, we have Coal India, which ended lower by 1.58%. This was after CLSA slashed target price to Rs. 240 from 245, following a cut in EPS estimates. Next we have in the list is Ultratech Cement, which again ended with losses, GAIL India and Infosys. However, the top gainer for the day remained India Bull Housing Finance. Back to Hadrian. Hadrian, something attractive that you're looking into housing finance space?
Yeah, so in the housing finance space, we are pretty bullish on Dewan Housing. That's one stock I feel where the buy on dip strategy really works. So when I'm talking about buy on dips, Dewan Housing has actually corrected from its peak, and now you're getting it around 430 odd levels. So when we say buy on dips, Dewan Housing is the best example to go with. This is something that you can accumulate even at these levels, and you can play for a target of around 465 to 470. We're expecting fresh highs even in Dewan Housing in the coming weeks.
We're not following the trend that we've seen the past few days when it comes to the broader markets and its market breadth. It continues to remain favorable towards advances, and that's what we've seen today. We have four gainers for three losers. And with respect to gainers, firstly, Titan. Of course, this is gained 17% on the back of the GST rates which have come in. And because of that, we've had plenty of upgrades coming in there as well from CLSA as well as Credit Suisse, Gathri Projects, and Tata Elxsi also gaining 10%. On the back of a license it has signed with a top original equipment manufacturer for the research and development of driverless cars. We have Bombay Dyeing, PC Jeweler, as well as DB Realty gaining substantially in today's day of trade. With respect to losers, we have Nitin Fire Protection declining by as much as 9.7%. Videocon Industries also down 5%, followed by weakness in Shilpi Cables, Marks and Pharma. So some of the usual suspects showing up once again on the losers list, with Aluwalia Contract, KPIT Cummins, as well as IFCI also declining substantially. That said, Adrian, you know, before I go to Titan, I know that you were talking to us about United Spirits. What is your call there?
Yeah, see, United Spirits is, you know, something that has done very significant on the charts. So in my opinion, it has already given a double bottom breakout. Now, this is something that, you know, traders should not miss out on, because you get these breakouts on a very rare occasions. So McDowell's is something that I'm really bullish on with a short-term perspective, and I'm expecting, you know, targets of around 2700, 2750 if you have the patience and if you have, you know, the likes of playing on the volatile stocks like stock like McDowell's. So this is something that we are pretty bullish on. Don't miss out on McDowell's.
Adrian, Titan now closing today at 551. It's gained 17%. Continue to be bullish?
Yeah, surely. Titan is one stock that we've been bullish on since 450 levels. And I think this is one stock that has actually given us this thrust after today's you know, big boost. So we'll continue to remain bullish on Titan, and we're expecting you know, target of around 600 plus if you have the perspective of another month or two. So Titan is something right. that you should really hold on to if you're bullish on.
There you have it, guys. We are keeping an eye on United Spirits as well as Titan going into today. But you know, Adrian, thank you for once again for joining us. It was a pleasure speaking with you, and as for you guys, well, we see you once again tomorrow on another edition of Market Wrap. Till then, it's goodbye.